should point to a game that led to an amazing turnaround for Michigan as they get ready for this Rose Bowl. You needn't look any further than the fourth quarter against Minnesota on October 10th. Trailing 28-7 and coming off a pair of losses in their last three games, it looked as though the season was drifting away to disappointment. But in the final 15 minutes, this Michigan team put on a show of grit and character that astounded everyone. Led by John Navarre and Chris Berry on offense, Michigan became unstoppable. The defense chipped in during the charge, too. An interception for a score by Jacob Stewart left the Gophers reeling in their own stadium. And incredibly, with 47 seconds left to play, Michigan lined up for a 33-yard field goal by Garrett Rivas to win it.
Here's the snap, placed down, Rivas kick on the way, high enough, long enough, and it is good! And with 47 seconds to play, Michigan has taken the lead at Minnesota 38-35.
The 38-35 win over the Gophers catapulted Michigan to a stretch run for the ages. They followed the Minnesota win with a 56-14 drubbing of Illinois. Then came 10th-ranked Purdue. But this was no contest as the Michigan offense rolled early.
Offset eye, power right, Navarre dropping the throw. He fires, goal line, caught, touchdown, Braylon Edwards. Breston to the left, and here's a draw play to Perry, and a handoff on a reverse to Breston with blockers in front. Pearson in the bar, upfield 15 to the 10, cuts back in at the 5, touchdown Stevie Breston, 21 yards on the reverse.
While the offense was impressive, this was a game for the defense. The Wolverines didn't let the high-powered Boilermaker passing game breathe. They sacked Kyle Orton 7 times. They stuffed the run when Purdue tried it. They intercepted a pair of passes, and they even scored their own touchdown in a dominating day at the Big House.
Handoff to Jones at left. Bumbo! The ball is out at the 2, picked up by Marcus Curry, and he'll walk into the end zone for a Michigan touchdown.
The 31-3 final over Purdue put the Wolverines into another big test at highly ranked Michigan State. Against the Spartans, Michigan featured old-fashioned football. They ran it right at them. Chris Perry was the warrior, carrying a record 51 times for 214 yards.
Third down and goal, a foot away or less. John Navarre under center, Perry and Dudley behind him. Gives it to Perry, over the top. Touchdown, Michigan! Chris Perry is in.
John Navarre added 3 touchdown passes when Perry wasn't gashing MSU on the ground, and Michigan won a not as close as it sounds 27-21 decision. After routing Northwestern 41-10 in their next game, Michigan's defining moment in 2003 would be against Ohio State in the finale, and a defining moment it was.
Navarre to throw, has time against the blitz, firing on a post, Edwards, he's got it! Touchdown, Michigan! A record tire for John Navarre! 23 yards out for the score, and it's 20-0. They got 146 on the ground against the number one rush defense in the land. Here's Perry again. High steps at left side, breaks outside, the 10, the 5, touchdown, Chris Perry! From 15 yards out, he scores again!
Navarre exercised his demons against the fourth-ranked Buckeyes, and Perry was his phenomenal self, gaining 154 yards and scoring twice behind a dominant offensive line that overpowered one of the nation's best run defenses. It was as complete a performance as you could ask from a team. The Michigan defense got in on the fun by stuffing Ohio State's running game and forcing them into being one-dimensional. It all added up to a glorious 35-21 Big Ten outright title, Rose Bowl clinching victory for Michigan. The Southern California run to the Roses in Pasadena was just as impressive, but their turnaround didn't come from a point in the season. Rather, it came from the beginning of the year when youngsters took over for graduated seniors and performed beyond their years. Let's face it, you don't expect to replace a Heisman Trophy quarterback in Carson Palmer and 3 senior running backs and keep the same production, do you? Well, at USC, they not only replaced those guys, but the replacements were even better. Matt Leinart stepped in at quarterback and actually put up better numbers than Palmer's Heisman year. Leinart has thrown for less yards, but his QB rating is higher, and he's thrown 2 more touchdowns and 1 less interception. They returned 2 1,000-yard receivers from a year ago, including all-everything wideout Mike Williams. How about the running game? With 1 sophomore and 2 true freshmen taking over for 3 seniors, USC has rushed for more yards this year than it did last. The new guys, Lendale White, Herschel Dennis, and Reggie Bush, have rushed for more than 1,800 yards combined. In addition, the Trojans rushed for more than 20 yards a game more than they did a year ago as a team. So the turnover of talent at such key positions hasn't led to a production deficit. It's led to a production increase. On defense, it's more of the same for USC, and yet, Despite only six starters returning on the defensive side of the ball, their defense may be even better. The strength of this defense is their defensive line. They are nicknamed the Wild Bunch 2 to honor a past USC defensive front that just so happened to play Michigan in the Rose Bowl of 1970. They give up just 61 yards a game rushing, 20 yards fewer than a year ago. They have more sacks, interceptions, and fumble recoveries than a year ago. So for a team that last year was 11-2 and made their way to a BCS Bowl in Routed, Iowa, and lost some high-profile, highly skilled players, they sure have not lost a step. If anything, they've gotten better. Two different kinds of turnarounds for Michigan and USC in 2003. For the Wolverines, it came during a fourth-quarter blitz at midseason. For the Trojans, it came in the very fertile ground of their recruiting classes. Clearly, both teams have turned it around, but Lloyd, from your perspective, looking at Southern Cal, losing a Heisman Trophy quarterback, all their running backs, All-American on defense, they've done a great job of retooling, haven't they?
They've done an unbelievable job, Jim. When you look at Matt Linhart stepping in and doing a great job, really a Heisman Trophy candidate as a sophomore, and they have two of the most highly touted freshman backs in the country in Bush and White, two great talents.
Would you say your turnaround was that fourth quarter in Minnesota?
Well, I think you have to say that, you know, when you're facing removal from the Big Ten race and a certain defeat. I think that certainly was the turning point of our season.
Well, you got it done, and you're here in Pasadena now, and when we come back, we'll take a look at some more of our Rose Bowl preview, but first we hear from Tony Pape, who says, no matter how USC turned it around, they haven't seen anybody quite like Michigan just yet.
We've been extremely well in keeping our offense balanced, and that's, I think, why we're so lethal as an offense. You know, we keep it on the ground, and, you know, we have threats on the ground and throw in the air when it's there. So I think we keep defense on their toes.
That was going to be a big challenge. You know, they're very explosive on both sides of the ball. You know, we got to go out there. We got to limit them from big plays in order to win the game, but they got a lot of weapons. They can get the ball into a lot of different people's hands.
Well, there's no question in the world, as you heard from Carl Diggs, USC is formidable. But, Coach, what's your take on all this BCS mess, and are they the best in the country?
Well, Jim, I voted them number one in the nation, but I think the truth is we've always had controversy in college football going back to the polls, the beginning of the polls, back in your day in the 50s. And so,
Wait a minute. I was in the 70s.
You weren't around.
I was in the
70s. I'm sorry, Jim.
Give it a rest.
I misspoke.
Give it a rest on that one, would you?
Well, we're going to have controversy forever, and that's good.
Well, the one thing that's interesting is Pete Carroll, the head coach of Southern California, has been saying all the right things in regards to this BCS controversy, where he's rated number one by the humans and number three by the machines.
We've got an incredible matchup with a great Michigan team. We're the number one team in America, and we're going to try to hold on to that and be the national champs. So we look at this as the Rose Bowl is the national championship game for us, and I don't think there's any denying that. So I know there's controversy and all of that, but that's kind of what comes along with a system like this, and until you play it off, you're not going to know any better. So we're thrilled about this opportunity. We can't wait to go play that game against Michigan.
Carroll certainly took the high road in all of this, and you can understand why. He's already rated number one by somebody, and if he wins the Rose Bowl, he'll claim the national title. From Michigan's perspective, it's the same story. If they're going to play the nation's number one ranked team, then it's got to be a game for the national title, right? Why not?
First of all, we're given a chance to play USC, who's the number one team in both human polls. So by us getting a chance to play them, I mean, if they're number one and we beat them, what does that say about us? So definitely we're looking at it as a chance to get respect, a chance to play a team, and who knows what happens along the BCS lines and the human voters. Something may happen where we might get a shot to share the title, so who knows how it's going to play. So this is definitely a national title game for us, too.
They can say whatever they want about it. For us, I mean, it's a Rose Bowl and a great place for us to be. So I don't really have a reaction towards it. I mean, obviously, it's a great chance for us to play a number one ranked team in the country. So if we can beat a team that everyone thinks is the best, it says a lot about us and how we end the season.
They're the number one team in the nation, so of course they would say that, and we're proud to be playing the number one team in the nation. I mean, everybody wants to play the number one team. You beat the number one team, you feel like then you're number one. So it's great to be able to play the number one team in the nation.
Well, as a player or as a coach, you can really paint it any way you want to, Lloyd. One thing's for sure, it's a big game. It may be the best game of the bowl season.
Jim, when you're playing in the Rose Bowl, it's big. And when you're playing Southern California, who happens to be ranked number one, and you're playing for the Rose Bowl trophy, and a lot of other things in terms of the memories and the legacy that this team can leave. I think, you know, that there's enough there to play for, I'll assure you.
Well, there's no question about that. When we come back, we'll take a look at two great seniors who will be playing their last game in the maize and blue. But first, we hear from quarterback John Navarro, who says no matter who's ranked number one or what's riding on this game, what matters most is who's best prepared.
We do have a potent offense, and Big Ten is a lot different than the Pac-10. And, you know, we're going to have to game plan and work hard as much as we do. But we're going to have our hands full, so they have a good defense. But I think it's going to be a challenge for us and for them and the team to prepare us from this point on to the game harder. We'll have the best chance of winning.
To be good in anything, and I think John Navarro's had his struggles, Chris Perry's had his struggles, you and I have had our struggles, you know, but the truth is there's nothing greater about coaching than to watch two guys become great leaders. They're unselfish, they're guys that I'm going to remember fondly because they really represented to me what Michigan football's all about. It's about team, it's about doing your best, and it's about winning, and it's about being the right kind of people.
And they are the right kind of people. Here now is a Michigan replay salute to John Navarro and Chris Perry.
I'll never lose hope, never lose faith. There's much too much at stake. Upon myself, I must depend. I'm not looking for place to show I'm gonna win. When it's all said and done, my once in a lifetime won't be back again. Now is the time to take a stand. Here is my chance. That's why I'll never give up. Never give in, never let a ray of doubt slip in. And if I fall, I'll never fail. I'll just get up and try again. Never lose hope, never lose faith. There's much too much at stake. Upon myself, I must depend. I'm not looking for a place to show I'm gonna win.
Well, we're certainly going to miss those two, but we get a chance to see them one more time in the Rose Bowl against Southern Cal. Lloyd, this is where we talk a little bit about the game from a standpoint of X's and O's. What do you see for the folks at home watching on television as being a key to this game?
Well, I think, Jim, you have to start when you look back at the game. Who won the turnover battle? You know, that's something I think against USC, they're such an explosive offense. If you give them the ball at the short end of the field, you're going to find yourself down in a hurry. You have to take care of the football, and I think one of the things that we have to do defensively is cause some turnovers.
A lot of people are looking for a high-scoring game. Are you?
You know, I think that's interesting conversation because both teams are explosive offensively. I think both teams are better defensively than, you know, maybe their reputation. So I think it'll come down. There will be a lot of points scored if there are a lot of big plays. Defensively, we got to prevent big plays. And not only defensively, but in the kicking game.
Right, but since the Minnesota game, the defense has really been good at shutting down the big plays. The other teams have had to go the distance on you, and they haven't gotten big chunks.
Well, Jim, you know, the Ohio State game in the second half, they hurt us throwing the football. But my biggest concern is truthfully, this is as fast and athletic an offensive football team as I've seen. So we're not going to shut them down. They're going to get some points, but we have to do some things offensively to counter and then be good in the kicking game. Don't forget the kicking game.
Boy, I will never forget the kicking game. Neither should you. Good luck.
Thanks.
Happy New Year. Thanks for watching all season long. And everybody out there that's been a faithful Michigan Replay fan, Happy New Year and go Blue, everybody.